What is the source of creation? According to our current theories of astrophysics, in its first moments, all of the universe's energy exploded out of a single point, the singularity. The four-dimensional geometry of space-time unfolded through what became the cosmos. And with it came gravity, the fundamental force that ties all mass of the universe together. Waves of gravity echoed outwards from the ensuing cataclysms, much like waves of light, water, or sound. Over the eons, these gravitational forces compressed particles of dust and formed ever larger celestial bodies. Then, newborn worlds. Gravity again sculpted these raw landscapes into wildly intricate forms. Earth was created, an environment that provided the proper conditions for the chemical collision that one day produced life. And finally, the human being. From our microscopic origins, we have since advanced our scientific instruments to be able to detect those gravitational waves of the early universe. Converting them to waves of sound, we can actually listen to the collision of black holes and other great interstellar events, the very music of cosmic creation. And as we continue on to map the space and time of our universe, we develop new techniques to harness the potential of that same gravitational energy for our own creations.
I would love to look into where creativity really comes from. Could be some other multidimensional world. Could just be from our brains, I don't know. I mean, there's deep, faceted layers of experiencing life, and energies that you've collected start to translate into your overall being, your well-being, and how you're gonna write music and your creativity, and start to, you know, mold who you are. I think those come from both within and from without. Times it's just stacking of events and adventures and experiences. It's a very opportunistic, optimistic thought, getting the inspiration to write the music from going outside. Combining the two things is one of the most powerful equations in my life. I think creativity really is like seeing a wave headed your way. And every wave's different, like every song's different.
I think you definitely have to be a bit of a weirdo to want to surf in places like this. I don't know, maybe I'm just weird. I was waiting right there, away from. I was standing right there and I
Jizzik juices are all the ingredients that go into the blender for when I finally sit down, write music. Everything that I've eaten up, seen, tasted, smelled, it's like there's ingredients floating around everywhere. You just kind of like run into them and collect them and then create your little life smoothie.
Really enjoyed that puzzle side where you've got to kind of figure it out, make guesses, and when those all come to fruition, that's the best thing ever for me.
Personally, it takes true human experience and putting the tunes fully in the backseat to get something that I just love. It's when I feel the most alive, the most present, the most joy. You're not anywhere else. Those are the big explosive moments that end up going into the music.
Top five greatest moments of my life, I'd say.
I think that's what I try to achieve in my music. It just completely describes the feeling that we all have in that same sunny moment. And we'll just keep experiencing it over and over again with each press of the play button.
Now I'm drinking a green smoothie. Epic.
Modern scientific observation tells us that as waves of gravity ripple through space, so too do they ripple through time. What we experience as gravity is in fact the result of matter warping both space and time. Being further away from the center of a gravitational source results in the speeding up of time, while being closer to that source will result in time slowing down. So a person by the sea will have a different experience of time than a person on a mountaintop. Time is likewise altered by movement and velocity, and even by the gravitational waves that still pulse through the cosmos. Time then, just like space, can be bent, curved, and manipulated. And thus, it is an equally essential instrument in the creation and fundamental nature of our universe.
I've struggled with, like, okay, I haven't written a song that I enjoy in a long time. And I think I was just trying so insanely hard, because you're just trying to mimic something that's already been created, or trying to dig up this part of yourself that feels like you're lying to yourself. But when I write a good song, I'm chipping away at something that's always been there. And there's definitely a sense of, it needs to sound like this.
You just have to start going with some form of no clue, and then the momentum comes with it.
The human experience is to try to grasp this larger connectivity and our place in it.
Are finally finding something on your guitar that you've never found before, the door's open and you're like, that's where I've been storing all those experiences. And those are those creative juices I've been looking for. That's the flow. Two chords down, I'm feeling awesome. Then you add the third, then you add the fourth, and then you add a synth. Everything starts to add and layer, and it starts to just sound awesome. It's happening. Sparks are flying. Patience, you will eventually stumble upon something that gives you a creative outlet to release those joys and pains and all those other things you've been experiencing in life. Once you're able to surrender, you fully explode in your own personal style. That just comes with time.
Being in this really remote, exposed place, we've seen energy at its greatest expression. We are all connected to that energy, and we are that.
I like to refer to flow state as personal melting, because it can transport you to a different time or a different place. It's time and space travel.
It's also just fun. It's so fun. When dancing to your own song, just stoked. Almost feels like a pre-written story sometimes when you write something that you really like. And it's just a one-way road, and you just have to follow it.
The dynamics of space-time ultimately cannot be considered without a third essential component, an observer. That is to say, you. This convergence of space, time, and relative observer is the foundation of the theory of relativity. This framework of physics tells us that any interpretation of space or time must be based on an observer's exact position relative to those phenomena. It has even been hypothesized that without this unique point of view, neither space nor time could exist, and that perhaps it is consciousness itself that creates the reality perceived as space-time. And so it follows that even us infinitesimally small human beings, as observers of our universe, may play a fundamental role in its very nature, simply by being and by listening.
Music to me, it's like a free ticket to joy. Having your instrument and having your tool, you're able to access deep parts of yourself and deep parts of the world. Digging into being the best version of yourself and creating only what you want to hear, what's going to come out. Coolest thing you've ever heard.
I assume jumping on stage to play a show would have a similar feeling to those moments where you're on the edge of your board and about to drop in. Your rail catches, you're standing in the barrel, and you know that you're in for a session. I can't imagine the rush. You know that I would, you know that I could tell you that I know that I'm in love.
Everyone has their own energy and everyone's coming from their own experiences and their own life to experience the same thing all together. And I look out, like the whole room is just this thick atmosphere of joy. Everything else kind of just falls off the face of the earth.
You can feel the rhythm in your life. You can feel the rhythm in the elements. You can feel the waves that come and go in your personal human experience.
We all have our own instruments in life. Whether you're a snowboarder or a surfer or a musician, you have your way to hone in on the world.
Whatever gives you that personal melt moment, that's where I see the progression in the human experience going.
I just think it's so important to have something like that in your life, and I'm just lucky I found it.
Once you've given up on trying to perform and try to be perfect and you drop all that, you just realize you're out there to have a great time. And they really just want to see you having a great time. That's just how I've discovered to find deep joy in music. Taking the pressure off of trying to be that thing and just enjoy that thing. I'm not a surfer, I'm not a musician. I just love doing those things. There's like no structure to it. It's beautiful and it's chaos.
What is the source of creation? For all we think we know, we live in a universe of questions and theory. There is still much to discover about our relative place and potential in this great continuum of space and time. But as we continue to push into untold dimensions, one thing remains certain. New horizons of creation and creativity await humankind. Hidden in the rhythms of a cosmic music we must now learn to hear.
I'm supposed to like dig deep?
Yeah, this is where we're getting conceptual.
Yeah, okay.
I'm doing a Hail Mary here.
I don't know where I'm going with any of this. I don't know if any of this is making any sense whatsoever.
I'm just like speaking shit gibberish.
Like whatever that personal melting is, factually, I don't care. I'm just looking for the personal melting. But if science helped me get it more personal melting,